source snowball, add. All right, now. Check, 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 check. Hey, can you hear me now? Can you hear me now? It's super quiet. I'm super quiet. Okay, why is... It says the volume's all the way up on this thing. I have no idea why. Let's go into... oh, man, I don't even know. Performance mode? No. Can hear on OBS. Yes. Is it still, am I still really quiet? You can boost gain as I filter in OBS. Oh, okay. We're gonna do that. Filters, where'd you go? There you are. Plus, gain, done. Joop, check, 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 check. Done, check, hello. Hello, check, check. It actually sounds all right with game audio. Do I sound all right? Sounds good? Okay, here we go. Let's rock. And we're back. Do I need to turn the game audio down, or can you guys still hear me fine? Right, wait for the wind. So I can get that over there. Excellent balance. Alright, good. Thank you, everybody. Okay, so what I just picked up now is called an empty blood vial. What that's gonna do is give me an extra health potion, essentially, I thought. The trick is I need to go get it filled. And that costs what are Tears of Atonement, which are basically the currency in the game. You see it over at the top right. And you get that by killing stuff, pretty much. But when you die, you lose them. Jump and then hit the wall in order to get up there. So it's a little, if you're not paying attention, you lose it. I guess I didn't lose too many tears. Look at that. Oh, that's just a tear. Sorry, I got out of my... You get these things called, you like, its tone, I guess, tries too hard to be creepy. Like, I feel like Bloodborne, Dark Souls kind of was, like, the right amount. I guess some of the, like, things that happen in this game. I also feel like I got a beta against the church. Yeah, exactly. It's 100% Bloodborne, but 2D. But it's got a lot more, it's very Catholic Church infused. It was made by a Spanish team. And you kind of get, once I learned that, I was like, oh, it really feels very Spanish. Like, in terms of its music and the aesthetic. No! Crap on a spatula. I don't know why I like this game so much. It's so hard. We're moving on. Basically my corpse, and I need to pick it up, and I can get back, it's a little brown part, looks like a bunch of vines going around my blue meter bar over there. Pick it back up, there we go, and get it away. Can't get that down there yet. How do I want to do this? Is there a seam over here? Nope, I can get it my blood vial filled. Fill her up. Alright, there we go. Now we got three. There, when you turn red, I didn't get a chance to do it, but that's called an execution. Sometimes you can trigger like an instant kill on after you hit him. What? No, what? Oh, man. Thank you. go the distance. Resistance to falls, eliminating recovery time. I don't need this equipped now, so what else we got here? What else do I have? The stone security reveals the vitality of okay. Go with that. We're gonna go with that and increase my defense. Change your turn to an object. Extra health. Recovers health when destroying surrounding objects. Okay. Blast in his dance. That's what you do when you're waiting. You know, this guy likes to get down. Up! And over. That was close. Alright. Getting close to the. It's the convent. Convent of the. This dude.
Indeed, sister of mine. Our encounter is approaching. The miracle will protect me. I do not need your protection this time.
Okay, dude.
Leave me alone.
See, they introduce these characters and then give you no context as to what they're even doing. I just know that this guy popped up once, said some gibberish like that, never popped up again, said some more gibberish, then eventually you fight him after he says some more gibberish. So, Saturday has been really good. Side. How did I open this thing again? I don't know. Just gonna really pick it up. Da-da-da-da. Hammer there. Now I can take this one all the way down. Is there anything I need to do in the village? Those are quest items. Quest. There you go. Ooh, I need to get that rosary put together. And I got Quicksilver. Okay. Yeah, we got, let's do that. So, Quicksilver, you'll give this guy, and he'll strengthen your bile flasks. And you get remnants of things you find in the hair. You get Peppa's dog. Yeah, puppy, yeah, puppy. Quicksilver guys over there, so I'm going the right direction. And the rosary beads make us equip more, equip more rosary beads, which gives you more. Advantages. No, not that one. This one. And then I think I've got the get some more remains. Let's go in here and turn those in. You turn those in here. And get some more Tears of Atonement. No? Nothing? Nothing more next time? Doggone.
Two faces greet you, penitent one. My name is Nacimiento. Look at my chest, upon which an ancient visage grows older and older. Mm-hmm. A face that does not speak, that does not think, while mine becomes younger, such that I now look like a child. Such a terrible sentence is this, that I do not understand its purpose. No matter how much I reflect on the sin that I may have committed to deserve it, the grace of the miracle is present even in those who are punished. Perhaps I might reduce the magnitude of this sentence by helping you. Bring me the quicksilver, which is capable of flourishing under our feet in any place at the whim of the grievous one, and I will mix it with the bile from your flasks, thereby enhancing its gift. Graceful be the heart.
Thank you.
With this silver,
see, now we only have two, but they heal more.
I bless.
So by the end of the game, you should have only three, but you're collecting like tons of them. You can collect like eight or nine. Or have a total. And the Rosary Lady is over there. I can't get to her until I can get down there, so that's gonna have to wait. Yeah, I think I have to go up through there. That's how you do it. Okay. Well, back to the elevator.
The miracle.
So, occasionally you'll collect like different like healing items, like herbs and junk. You give them to him, and he'll give you like different items, beef you up.
Thank you.
so dumb. I had a feeling you might like it. It's like, it's very Castlevania, but not. I like it a lot. Thank you. No. Whew. That was close. I'm gonna go explore down here real quick. go. Execution performs, like, fix the arrow staticky and hurts people. Alright, let's go fight this guy and call it a stream.
Penitent one, do not be troubled by me or my outward appearance, now changed and seasoned. This might be a small price to pay for such joyous alliance.
Basically, this
my protection does not cease here.
Hurts
will
herself.
You require my assistance with your next task?
Sure.
So be it.
She ends up basically sacrificing herself to keep you alive. It's dark. I mean, I guess you could go through the game without Oh yeah, this boss was hard. Just wrapping it up. Phew. This little bit of creepy goodness. This is my second visage to get. So you're trying to get three visages, open a door, and then you got to get three masks.
In the name of the great ordeal and the sons of the miracle, may the gold in my visage melt and erase the compunction of your soul. Heart of guilt, return now from the dream.
Thank you, Mr. Wolfus. They call him Goldie. Goldie for sure. Don't actually call him that. Good. Gold dinner for the burning oil. Awesome. Now I gotta give that back to the other guy. That's part of a side quest.
You have carried out the second humiliation of penance. You have been allowed to behold the visage of compunction. You have yet to prostrate before one last holy visage.
If by prostrate you mean murder another boss, sure, I'll go prostrate. And I'm gonna level up that sword. Booyakasha! So every time you find one of these shrines, see, now we're at level 2, and you can spend your points, upgrade, get some new moves, and the level is basically the strength of your sword, so you can get all the way up to like level 7. So eventually you can start one-shotting fools, and it's pretty fun. By the end of the game you feel really powerful, because right now you feel really weak. Let's see, let's get the most expensive one first. Ooh, yes. So I can throw my sword. I'm gonna get this one. I'm gonna get this one. 7,000. And this one is 2,300. Okay. Cool. Man, I just gained a ton there. Alright, that's been Super Gamer Boys. Be sure to tune in later today at 4 o'clock for JJ as he plays through Fortnite, which will be a lot of fun, because JJ is a riot. He's a character, that guy. So, thank you for watching. This has been Zetch Keenan, Nerd Dad Zetch, and I'm out.